happy Sunday, everyone. It's time for your tropical update as we move into your Sunday afternoon and Sunday evening, and we continue to monitor Fred. That's right, Fred has now regained its tropical storm strength earlier this morning and is now really beginning to organize better. You can see the thunderstorms blowing up near the center, and notice the thunderstorms and the clouds trying to wrap around the center a little bit there. So that's telling us this storm is starting to get a little more organized. So it's a 40-mile-per-hour tropical storm as of the 2 o'clock advisory. I would not be surprised to see this starting to strengthen as we go into the evening hour. So be aware of that as it slowly moves off towards the north in the eastern Gulf of Mexico. The latest track from Tropical Storm Fred does have this still making landfall sometime Monday night. Notice the track has shifted back to the east a little bit. Now expected to make landfall there in the Florida Panhandle as we get into your Monday night. Could be a decent-sized tropical storm, so we're going to watch this. I wouldn't be surprised to see these numbers go up a little bit more. But notice that the remnants of Fred will start to move into our area as we get into your Tuesday night into Wednesday. So Tuesday into Wednesday is when I do expect the most impacts from Fred locally, but we'll start to see those impacts as early as tomorrow morning. We have tropical storm warnings that are in effect now along the Florida Panhandle and tropical storm watches as well, as we are now expecting a landfalling tropical storm as we get into the next 24 hours or so. And you can see the storm surge forecast. We've got a storm surge watch for the Big Bend of Florida there. They're expecting 2 to 4 feet of water to kind of pile up there, right there in the Big Bend there. It kind of scoops it in. And that's before the heavy rain moves in. So flooding from that wall of water and then flooding potentially from that heavy rainfall. And look at the rainfall track with this system. As it makes landfall Monday night, you can see that heavy rainfall approaching areas where they're going to be seeing that high storm surge. But then notice as the remnants move our way heading into Wednesday, Tuesday into Wednesday, look at this corridor of just some very heavy rainfall along and north of I-85, especially where we're looking at the potential. You can see those numbers getting close to 6, 7, 8 inches in some spots. But I do think at least a widespread average of 3 to 5 inches is going to be likely. With that being said, there is a elevated flood threat risk for us across the Carolinas and Georgia, and this does include the entire viewing area as we go into next week, where we are likely going to be seeing some flash flooding. We're going to be seeing some flooding from rivers and creeks and streams rising as well. And then also we're going to be looking at that potential of some landslides, especially in the mountains, because of all that water and it having to run down and run off there. So next week is going to be a little bit on the wet side as we go into your Monday, Tuesday, into Wednesday, but it's also going to be dangerous in the fact that we could have some flooding and also some landslides that we've got to watch out for. So with that being said, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday are alert days. Of course, we've been talking about this for the past several days now. As that tropical moisture arrives, we are expecting the concern of heavy rain and flooding conditions there. And again, on average, 2 to 5 inches of rainfall. But I think there will be likely some spots that are going to see more than 5 inches of rainfall, and it could be closer to that 7, 8 inch mark. So we've got to watch this closely. Thankfully, the system will actually be moving at a decent clip. It's not going to kind of stall out across the area, so that will at least be some benefit. Hey, let me give you an update real quick on Tropical Storm Grace as well, which is now making its way through Puerto Rico. You can see very disorganized at this time and is expected to continue to basically move right over Hispaniola. And we saw what it did with Fred when it moved over the mountainous terrain and then along Cuba. So this system could weaken for a while before maybe emerging in the Gulf of Mexico by the end of the week. And then it could start to strengthen. Where it will go? Well, right now it looks like the model data is keeping it moving west along the Gulf of Mexico. So this could be more of a Louisiana, Texas storm. But again, this is way out there. We have plenty of time to watch this and fine tune it. Now, if that wasn't enough for you, let's add another system in there. That's right. We've got Tropical Wave, or what we call an INVEST 96L. This is out near Bermuda. This does have a 40% chance of developing here over the next couple of days. The interesting thing about this is it will start to drift off to the south and west, but eventually should begin to turn back out to the north and east and stay away from land. But of course, that's just another system that we'll have to keep our eyes out on here coming up in the future. But for right now, here's a look at your Tropical Storm Fred headlines. Of course, the storm is getting stronger in the Gulf of Mexico. Landfall is expected Monday night. We're going to be expecting waves of rain to begin starting on your Monday, and that looks like that rain will pick up in intensity and coverage and become the heaviest Tuesday through Wednesday. That's going to be the prime time that you will definitely need to be concerned about the potential of some flooding, landslides, and yes, even the potential of also seeing some of those rivers and creeks and streams rising in your neighborhoods and those water levels rising as well. So we could be looking at many people talking about some lakefront properties here May not know it yet, but it may be happening as we go throughout this week. Of course, we'll have a full update for you tonight at 6 and 11. Until then, stay safe and stay up to date.